So in this video, we will study about the a very common injury of the foot, which is the fifth metatarsal base fractures. So very commonly encountered in our emergency and OPD setup. So just of base, fifth metatarsal fractures, they are very common. So starting with the anatomy. So this is the fifth metatarsal. So the various parts of the fifth metatarsal. So this is the base of the fifth metatarsal, the proximal most part. It is the base of the fifth metatarsal. So it has a laterally as a tubercle or tuberosity. Then we have the metaphyseal diaphyseal junction between the base and the shaft. So we have the shaft of the fifth metatarsal. Then we have the neck of the fifth metatarsal, and distally we have the head of the fifth metatarsal. Now the various structures that are attached to it. So in base, over the tuberosity, we have the attachment of the tendon of the peroneus brevis and the lateral band of the plantar fascia. And over the proximal diaphyseal region, over the dorsal aspect, we have the attachment of the peroneus tertius. So peroneus tertius and peroneus brevis tendons are attached over the fifth metatarsal. Now the fractures are classified into various zones. So we have the various zones. So as seen here, so the tuberosity forms the zone 1, the metaphyseal diaphyseal junction, they forms the zone 2, and zone 3 is formed by the proximal diaphyseal region. So these are the three zones. So why it is divided into three zones? Because mode of injury is different and management is different for each of the three zones. Another peculiar feature of the base of the metatarsal is the blood supply. So the proximal most part, the tubercle is supplied by the metaphyseal arteries, and the distal part is supplied by the nutrient artery. So this creates a watershed area, and an avascular zone is created in the metaphyseal diaphyseal region, which is responsible for the non-union in this region. Now one by one, starting with the zones. So to begin with, we have the zone 1, which is the proximal tubercle avulsion fracture. So it is the avulsion fracture of the tuberosity. So the mode of injury is different in every zone. So we will discuss, and management is different for every zone. So zone 1 is the proximal tubercle avulsion fracture. Only the tuberosity or the tubercle is avulged because of the pull of the peroneus brevis tendon. So mode of injury is the hind foot inversion. So it is the hind foot which goes into inversion. So which is responsible for the avulsion fracture of the tubercle. So as we have discussed that blood supply is rich in this region, so non-union is very uncommon. And because of that fact, conservative management can be started in the form of protected weight-bearing cast for 6 to 8 weeks. So a protected weight-bearing is allowed in the cast for 6 to 8 weeks. Then we have the zone 2. So as we have discussed, zone 2 is the metaphyseal-diaphyseal junction. So zone 2 is the metaphyseal-diaphyseal junction. So it involves the 4th and the 5th metatarsal articulation. So another important point in anatomy is the medial side of the base of the 5th metatarsal. So on the medial side, we can see there is articulation between the metatarsal and the cuboid here, and there is articulation between the intermetatarsal, between the 4th and the 5th metatarsal. So we have a joint known as the metatarsal cuboid joint and an intermetatarsal joint. Now the fracture of the proximal tubercle avulsion, they are mostly extra-articular, and rarely they can involve the cuboid and the metatarsal joint. But for the fracture of the zone 2 in the metaphyseal diaphyseal junction, they involve the 4th and the 5th metatarsal articulation. So they will be in this region at the metaphyseal diaphyseal junction. So they will involve the 4th and the 5th metaphyseal metatarsal articulation. So as we have discussed, this is a watershed area. So non-union rates in non-operative management is common, around 10 to 30%. And the mode of injury is again different. The mode of injury is forefoot adduction. So it is the forefoot adduction which will cause the fracture at this region. And this is an acute injury. So this is important fact that this is acute injury. So on X-ray, there will be a fresh margin of the fractures. Now coming upon to the zone 2. So zone 2, as we have discussed, that it is a proximal diaphyseal region. So zone 2 is the proximal diaphyseal region, which is distal to the 4th and the 5th metatarsal articulation. So this is the 4th and the 5th metatarsal articulation. So zone 2 fracture will be in the proximal diaphyseal, which is distal to the articulation between the 4th and the 5th metatarsal. So mostly it is a chronic, as because it is a stress induced fracture mostly seen in athletes. So it is a chronic injury. So the on X-ray there will be sclerosis and the fracture lines won't be fresh as seen in the zone 2. So in zone 3 there will be sclerosis at the fracture margin and fracture line won't be fresh margins, won't be having fresh margins. So mostly they what all people are prone to have stress fracture, they will be have an associated deformities in the form of cavovirus deformity of the foot or associated sensory neuropathies may be present in those patients having stress fracture in the zone 3. So zone 1, 2 and zone 2, they fall in the watershed area. So non-union is very common in case of the zone 1 and zone 2 and zone 3 injuries. So we can go for the non-weight bearing cast in general population for 6 to 8 weeks, but for patient who have athletic activity, we can go for the intramedullary screw fixation. So intramedullary screw fixation can be done in athletes, so who want to recover early to the activity. So this is the intramedullary screw fixation. So it is important to note that there is, even after fixation, there are still signs of delayed union or the bone is still uniting phase. So which can be because of the various factor that patient has started early weight bearing before the radiological union, or the screw is not of adequate size. So normally a solid canceller screw or 4.5 or 5 mm should be inserted. A smaller screw will allow a motion at this segment and a non-union can occur. Now to diagnose non-union, we have to go for the CT scan. So usually CT scan is not done in emergency setting. X-rays are sufficient to diagnose the metatarsal base fracture. So why they are classified into the various zones? So what is the need? Because the management, the mode of injury is different in all the three zones. So a common nomenclature that is used for the fifth metatarsal base is the zones fracture. So but we should know that it is only the zone 2 fractures which are known as zones fracture. So not all the base fractures are known as zone fracture. It is only the zone 2 fractures, neither the zone 1 or no zone 3 fractures. It is only the zone 2 fractures that are occurring at the metaphyseal diaphyseal junction that will be known as the zone fracture. The avulsion fractures, they are known as pseudozones, because their management protocol is different. Pseudozones is the avulsion fracture of the tuberosity, while the zone fracture is a transverse fracture at the metaphyseal diaphyseal junction. So why is such differentiation between zones and pseudozones? because we have discussed that in zones there is high non-union rate because of poor blood supply, so we should go for the non-weight bearing cast or intramedullary screw fixation in athletes and young population. Whereas in pseudo zones is a vascular area, we can go for the protected weight bearing cast. So we can use the air cast or we can use a cast walker. Now few complication. In complication, we have discussed the non-union. Now x-rays, in x-rays there are two things that should be differentiated from the fracture. So this is not an avulsion fracture of the base. So this is basically os peroneum, which is a bone in the tendon of the peroneus brevis. So this is very common finding and we should be able to differentiate it from the avulsion fracture of the base. So this is os peroneum. So another thing that is seen in children is the active or open growth plate of the base. So in children there will be an open growth plate of the base which is parallel to the base of the fifth metatarsal. So these two finding we should be able to differentiate from the fracture. So this is open growth plate in case children aged from 9 to 13 years, and we have the, so this is the normal apophysis in children 9 to 13 year, and we have the os peroneum which is normally found in 30% of the general public. So this is the os peroneum. So that was about the fifth metatarsal base fractures. So important points is the that zones fracture is not the fifth metatarsal base fracture, it is only the second zone fracture, which is the zones fracture. And zone 1 is a pseudo zone fracture, and various os peroneum and the open growth plate that should be differentiated from the fifth metatarsal base fracture. So lastly, so this is the displacement which occur in case of the zones fracture or metaphyseal diaphyseal fracture or zone 2 fracture. So because of the pull of the tendon of the peroneus brevis, it is pulled proximally and laterally, while the shaft is pulled medially and superiorly by the pull of the peroneus tertius. Kindly comment down below any suggestion and queries, and keep supporting.